Hello dear students, welcome to EPG Pathshala. I am Harpreet Kaur, Assistant Professor, Khalsa College of Education, Ranjit Avenue, Amritsar. Today, we will discuss about the topic School Standards and their Evaluation. The main objective of this topic are to describe the concept of School Standard and Evaluation Framework, to enable the students to comprehend the key domains and core standards for evaluating performance of school, to outline the different approaches of school evaluation, to acquaint students regarding national program on school standards and evaluation. First of all, let us understand what we mean by concept of school evaluation for school improvement. Improving quality and performance of schools have been continuously reaffirmed in all the policy pronouncements. The school's education system in India is observing speedy expansion coupled with increasing diversity of the student population, the complexity of diversified context, rural, urban and tribal, composition of schools large and small, and condition provisioning are major challenges to achieve equitable quality education for all children in India. Right-based approach to elementary education through enactment of Right to Education Act 2009 has emphasized accountability of schools. Rashtriya Madhyamik Shiksha Abhiyan clearly visualizes decentralizing school management and accountability as a means to improve school performance. Policy documents continue to emphasize access to schooling and concurrently aims to achieve quality in school education. The critical role of schools in the changing education context in terms of its effectiveness and improvement is gaining key importance for providing quality education for all children. There is greater realization that in view of the huge investment in terms of human and other resources in school education sector, the school needs to perform and deliver at its optimum level. The quality initiative in school education sector thus necessitates focusing on schools, its performance and improvement. Therefore, to meet the demand for high quality education, a growing emphasis is being placed upon comprehensive school evaluation system as they are central to improvement initiative. As we know that each school is unique to its own context, size, condition and provision, a school is an institution and a space for learning, having the mandate to translate national vision and curriculum in their true spirit. It has been acknowledged nationally and internationally that schools do matter and have major impact upon the development of learners, learning process and life of children. The school is now increasingly recognized as key agency to improve performance of learner and for realization of educational objectives. The focus is gradually shifting on schools to take initiative for their change and improvement in a progressive way. In other words, the school is visualized as an organization capable of reforming itself rather than being totally dependent on external support systems. Now, let us discuss the meaning of school evaluation. The term school evaluation refers to the evaluation of an individual school, its performance in a holistic manner. It is gaining importance as a means for empowering school to make professional judgment on critical performance areas. It facilitates the schools to understand their strength, opportunities for improvement, and on developing plans prioritizing actions, decision making, resources utilization, and creating evidence based support for their improvement. The purpose of school evaluation needs to be understood in the context of its role and contribution to wider goal of improving the quality of schools. It needs not be perceived as an exercise to identify the weaknesses or deficiencies in the performance of a school and expecting compliance of suggestion for interventions in respect of identified weaknesses or deficiencies. Currently, schools do not have a structured mechanism in place to systematically and honestly review and evaluate their performance. Hence, it is imperative to focus on every school as a point of delivery and improve its performance in a progressive manner through a continuous process of evaluation. School evaluation empowers the school as a whole to celebrate its change and encourages for sustainable transformation. School evaluation practices. Historically, school inspection and supervision by educational authorities has been considered as an instrument of school evaluation, the outcome of which is generally presented in the form of an inspection report. The inspection of school is generally conducted without criteria of evaluation and clearly written inspection guidelines. In recent years, the efforts have been initiated by some states to develop and implement structured school evaluation program against predetermined criteria of evaluation. The states like Gujarat, Karnataka, Odisha, Madhya Pradesh, etc. have taken positive initiative to improve quality of elementary education through school assessment monitoring and accreditation processes for which assessment and monitoring tools were developed. Each state has defined its own indicator, processes and approaches to assess school quality, though varied in nature. These practices are indicative of the fact that there is greater recognition for assessing school performance to improve quality of schools and learning level of children, particularly at the elementary level. These initiatives are based on the assumption that systematic school evaluation leads to improvement in the overall quality of schools and also performance level of teachers and students. So, students, these are practices used by school for evaluation. Now, let us discuss the theoretical perspective of school standard and evaluation framework. The school standard and evaluation framework is developed as a comprehensive instrument for school evaluation. It enables the school to evaluate its critical performance area against the well-defined criteria in focused and strategic manner. The school standard and evaluation framework is developed through a participatory approach involving state-level functionaries, district and block-level education officers, educators, school heads, teacher unions, teachers, etc. It is based on mutual consensus of all stakeholders on how to evaluate Indian schools to improve their performance. The school standards and evaluation framework has been piloted at each stage of its development. The major objective of school standard and evaluation framework is to establish and refer to an agreed set of key domains, core standards and processes which all schools must use as well defined criteria for school evaluation. It will provide a clear roadmap for each school to embark on journey of self and external evaluation, leading toward incremental school improvement with accountability. The salient feature of school standards and evaluation framework are identifies key domain as critical performance area and set of core standard under each core key domain as reference point for evaluating and improvement. A comprehensive instrument for both self-evaluation and external evaluation. flexible and adaptable for contextualization by the state addressing the needs of diverse schools. Clear, logical and easy to use by school and external evaluator. Makes the evaluation process consistent and transparent. Enable schools to evaluate their current level of performance and provide concrete direction toward the next level of improvement. From these features, it is clear that school standards and evaluation framework follows a very systematic approach. The conceptual framework is strongly supported by evidence-based national and international researches on school evaluation. It acknowledges the diversity of schools and students' cultural, linguistic, and socio-economic background. The school standard evaluation framework is developed the guiding principle of constitutional values, national policies on education, curriculum frameworks, etc., and is also in resonance with the Right of Children to Free and Compulsory Education Act. 2009. Rashtriya Madhyamik Shiksha Abhiyan and Sarv Shiksha Abhiyan, the principle of inclusion and equity are considered as the basic premises for developing the framework. The school standards and evaluation framework is strongly built on the notion of all children can learn and all school can improve. The school standards and evaluation framework comprises 7 key domains as the significant criteria for evaluating performance of schools. Each key domain has a set of core standards that addresses the most significant element of respective key domain. The evaluation of each key domain entails sequential steps. These steps are reflective prompts, factual information, core standards with descriptive content, supportive evidences which together facilitate school in making professional judgment of their level of performance. Each school is expected to prepare a consolidated evaluation report in the school evaluation dashboard. The school standard and evaluation framework is flexible for adaption, contextualization, and translation in the state-specific language. The structural arrangement of each key domain facilitates each school to evaluate their own performance in a systematic and professional manner with the support of evidences. Now, we will discuss this key domain and core standards involved in it. So, the first one is enabling resources of school availability, adequacy and usability. This key domain addresses the quality dimensions of schools, that is school premises, playground with sports equipment and materials, classrooms and other rooms, electricity and other gadget, library, laboratory, computer, ramp where provisioning exists, midday meal, kitchen and utensils, drinking water, hand wash facilities and toilets. Teaching, learning and assessment. In this key domain, measurable expectations included are teachers' understanding of learners, subject and pedagogical knowledge of teachers, planning for teacher teaching, enabling learning environment, teaching learning process, class management, learners assessment, utilization of teaching learning resources and teachers' reflection on their own teaching learning practices. Learners' progress, attainment and development. The elements covered in this domain are learners' attendance, learners' participation and engagement, learners' progress, learners' personal and social development, and learners' attainment. Managing teacher performance and professional development. Orientation of new teachers, teachers' attendance, assigning responsibilities and defining performance goal, teachers' preparedness for curricular expectation, monitoring of teachers' performance and teachers' professional development need to be taken into account to bring about holistic improvement. School leadership and management. It includes building vision and setting directions, leading change and improvement, leading teaching, learning, and management of school. Inclusion, health, and safety. Inclusive culture, inclusion of children with special needs, physical safety, psychological safety, and health and hygiene are setting benchmark for quality. Productive community participation. Organization and management of school, management committee, school development and management committee, role in school improvement, school community linkage, community as learning resource and empowering community are significant dimension of this key domain. For the evaluation of these core standards and approaches, these approaches are used. The school standards and evaluation framework is a strategic instrument for both self and external evaluation. Self-evaluation is considered as the nucleus of school evaluation process. It is intended to provide the school personnel with a common understanding of the school's overall performance and identify priority area for improvement. External evaluation follows as a complementary exercise to self-evaluation, so as to ensure that the two approaches work in synergy and respect to strengths and insights that each brings to the overall evaluation. It aims to develop a complete picture of school for supporting its overall improvement. The differences between self-evaluation and external evaluation. Self-evaluation is a continuous and cyclic process embedded in day-to-day activities of school. School as a whole acts collaboratively, involving all its stakeholders, including the school management committees, school development and management committees. Process of self-evaluation includes steps such as building preparedness among all stakeholders, collecting and analyzing evidences, recording judgment in the response matrix, preparing consolidated report in the school evaluation dashboard. Is undertaken throughout the term July to June, the consolidated report filled in school evaluation dashboard needs to be submitted at the end of the term. On the other hand, external evaluation is complementary exercise to self-evaluation to develop a complete and objective picture of school performance. Evaluators are external to the school and internal to the system, like educational officials, head teacher of the school, other public administrator, etc. Evaluators act as critical friend to school, analyze and review self-evaluation documents, seek additional information from teachers, parents, children, and other stakeholders, observe classroom practices and functioning of the school, give objective feedback to school, record judgment and prepare the evaluation report, provide support in prioritized area for improvement. Is planned for twice a year, typically as mid-term and end-term exercise. The state decides on the frequency of external evaluation as per their criteria. Student, now we will talk about self-evaluation guidelines for school evaluation. These are building preparedness, collecting evidences, capturing stakeholder voices, school observation, classroom observation, review of documents, identifying and recording status of school functioning, identifying strengths and opportunity for improvement, formulation of action for continuous improvement plan, integrating of action for continuous improvement plan with school development plan. And for external evaluation, all guidelines are same as of self-evaluation except these. examining the action for continuous improvement plan, examining integration of action for continuous improvement plan with school development plan. Beside this, the school standards and evaluation framework provide the broad guidelines to institutionalize school evaluation by the respective states. It encourages local adaptation by the state based on their socio-cultural context and state-specific policies. The framework is flexible for adaptation, contextualization, and translation in the state-specific language. After learning about evaluation approaches and guidelines, let us now explore the various instruments or facilities of on-school evaluation. So, the first one is School Evaluation Dashboard. The School Evaluation Dashboard facilitates each school to provide consolidated self-evaluation report in key performance domains and core standards. Including action for improvement, it has three parts. Basic information about learner and teachers, school evaluation composite metrics, which provide the holistic picture of school performance across seven key domains and their core standards, and action for continuous school improvement plan. The dashboard has also the provision for external evaluation report. The school evaluation dashboard is available online in a dedicated web portal. Each school can submit its self-evaluation report by using the interactive web portal. The external evaluator have to use the same web portal to provide their evaluation report. A consolidated school evaluation report encompassing both self and external evaluation is generated online by the web portal. The school evaluation dashboard can be used for viewing and analyzing school evaluation report and data, which can further be consolidated at the block, district, and state level to extend appropriate support to school. It also facilitates schools in monitoring their own progress and improvement over the years. It would further direct the schools to take appropriate action for its continuous improvement and allow for revising their practices. The consolidated data at the block, district, and state level can also direct policy level decision across the levels. Next is web portal. Web portal has all program related document which can downloaded by all the user. The web portal has an interactive platform wherein each school can submit its self-evaluation report online. The external evaluator have to use the same web portal to provide their evaluation report. A consolidated school evaluation report is generated online, encompassing both self and external school evaluation report. Each school can create its login ID by using UDISE code as login ID and can generate its password. Similarly, block, district, and state can create their login ID and password. The web portal has a most unique feature in that it has access to school evaluation report of any school by parents and public to observe and provide feedback. The web portal can be used by all the stakeholders as follows. School. School can create its login ID by using UDISE code as login ID and can generate their password. Feeds school self-evaluation data and action for school improvement online. Final submission of self-evaluation data generates school self-evaluation report. Next are external evaluator. External evaluator can also create login ID and password for the respective school. assess school self-evaluation report of the respective school, feed school external evaluation data, and generate external evaluation report. Another is consolidated school evaluation report. Generate online school evaluation report encompassing both self and external evaluation. Block, district, state, and national level. Create login ID and password for the block, district, state, and national level. Access evaluation report of each school. Monitor the process and progress at the block and district level. Generate summary of school performance. Evaluation and analyze the level in the respective domain and core standards at the block, district, state, and national level. So, student, till now we have learned about school standard and evaluation framework, different approaches and processes for school evaluation, guidelines for school evaluation, and about various instruments of school evaluation. Now, let us focus on the National Program on School Standard and Evaluation. The National Program on School Standard and Evaluation is an integral and holistic effort towards school evaluation. It aims to cover all the school of different size, context, and management over a period of time in a systematic and sustained manner. Operational structure of the National Program on School Standard and Evaluation. It is strongly believed that collaborative endeavor amongst experts, policymakers, and practitioners would provide the right direction for developing, implementing, and institutionalizing school standard and evaluation. The National University of Educational Planning and Administration is leading the program under the leadership of Ministry of Human Resource Development. A national technical group has been constituted comprising members from diverse institutions across the country to extend guidance and support. The National Program on School Standards and Evaluation visualizes the key role of the state in rolling out the program in turn spirit. It has acknowledged the school assessment and monitoring efforts taken by the states like Gujarat, Odisha, Karnataka, etc. for improving the quality of elementary education. Many other states are also initiating their effort towards assessing school performance. Hence, substantial number of states have the capacity and resource to contextualize and adapt the National Program on School Standards and Evaluation as part of National Program on School Standard and Evaluation initiative to engage with state technical groups is being constituted to take forward the state level tasks. It is also proposed to establish a unit on school standards and evaluation in each state. It is envisaged that the unit on school standard and evaluation in each state in close collaboration with state technical group, experts and teachers will engage in the development, adaptation and context-specific framework for school evaluation, guidelines for evaluation process, training, manual and build capacity on the critical mass of human resource for school evaluation. The state will also identify institutions, schools, universities, Department of Education to work in tandem for developing state-specific model of school evaluation. So we can say that the effective implementation of National Program on School Standards and Evaluation necessitates the development of material, building capacity of critical mass of human resource, institutional support and arrangement. Beside this, research, development of web portal and mobile application are activities related to each phase of National Program on School Standards and Evaluation Tasks. Students, let us discuss these tasks. So, firstly, development of material. These documents have been developed as a part of the NPSSE program. National Program on School Standard and Evaluation, a program document. School Standard and Evaluation Framework. Guidelines for School Evaluation. School Evaluation Dashboard and Web Portal. Next task is capacity building. In order to successfully roll out the program nationally, it is important to build capacity at the state, block, district and school levels by organizing regular meetings, trainings, workshops, etc. These capacity building programs aim to develop adequate competency at each level to understand the school standards and evaluation framework and evaluate school in a systematic and standardized manner. Next, we have institutional mechanism. The National Program on School Standard and Evaluation aims to institutionalize school evaluation by developing national, state and school level mechanism. It will collaborate with governmental institutions and professional experts at each level to the school standards and evaluation framework in its true spirit. National Program on School Standards and Evaluation also conduct research on state, national and international school evaluation practices to improve and enhance the school standards and evaluation framework regularly. Development of web portal and mobile application is another task of National Program on School Standards and Evaluation. In order to make the school evaluation report and improvement process easily accessible to all the stakeholders, including schools, web portal and mobile application is an integral part of National Program on School Standard and Evaluation operational plan. Lastly, it is concluded that school evaluation is a systematic and sustained approach to engage in inquiry and reflection to make school a better place for students, teachers, and community. Hence, school improvement fundamentally means improving what a school does through continuous evaluation. The National Program on School Standards and Evaluation is an initiative to institutionalize school evaluation for improving the quality of school education, both at primary and secondary level. It is an endeavor to support continuing evaluation of each school for its improvement and development. Thank you.